Hello and welcome to Bank Exams Today. So friends, today we'll solve that data interpretation sets. We'll solve two DIs here and we'll see that mains level exam mein kis tarah ke DIs aate hain aur unke liye kya approach honi chahiye, right? So before starting the session, I would like to introduce you to the new course that we have launched here for IBPS, RRB, Scale 2 GPU and for Scale 3 as well. So our team has prepared a full-fledged and a comprehensive course for the preparation of above said exams, and this course will contain video classes for all the sections along with complete study material provided in PDF formats, and a test series will also be there which will contain 10 full-length tests with chapter-wise tests also there, and a systematic study plan will also be there to guide you with interview preparation guidance for all the students who will clear the written exams. And apart from this, you can use this coupon code LK10. And for this, by doing this, you can avail 10% discount as well. So now starting the session here, as you can see a table here in which some values are missing. And this table shows the number of employees working in four companies named Mahindra, SsangYong, Kia and Denso. Now each company has total employees in the form, each company has some males and some females, right? And out of them, some are married and some are unmarried. Like in Mahindra, there are 632 employees, out of which 402 are males and rest of them are females. And out of those males and females, some are married and some are unmarried. So like 201 are married males and rest of the information is missing. Similarly, you can see in other three rows as well. So some values are missing in the table and you have to find the values on the basis of the given information. And also you have to answer the question accordingly. Clear? So let's see the very first question here. It says, if the number of unmarried females in Mahindra is 2 more than half of the number of married females. So if you see Mahindra mein total kitne employees hain, 632, out of which 402 are males. So obviously 632 minus 402 will be equal to the total number of females. So that is equal to 402 mein agar hum 30 jod do, 432 plus 200, 632. So total number of females is equal to 230. Clear? Now, as the statement says, number of unmarried females in Mahindra. Number of unmarried females in Mahindra is 2 more than half of number of married females. So let's just say married females are 2x. So according to statement, unmarried females will be half of 2x, that is x plus 2. 2 more than x. Now the question says, find the difference between unmarried males in Mahindra and unmarried females in Mahindra. Okay. So first of all, you see total number of females is equal to 230 and that should be equal to the summation of 2x plus x plus 2. Total married females or unmarried females bina ke total number of females only. Right. So that is equal to 228 is equals to 3x. And x is equal to 228 divided by 3, that is equal to 76. So number of married females is equal to twice of 76. So that is equal to 152. And unmarried females is equal to 76 plus 2, that is 78. Now you see total number of males are 402, out of which 201 are married. So obviously 201 are unmarried as well. Clear? Now, according to the statement, we have to find out the difference between unmarried males, that is 201, and unmarried females, that is 78. So the difference between 201 and 78, it is equal to 11 minus 8, 3, 9 minus 7, 2 and 1, 123. So this is your answer. Clear? Let's move on to the next one. The number of unmarried males in SsangYong is 26 more than number of married males. So see in SsangYong, the number of married males, it is equal to 215. And number of unmarried males are 26 more than that. So 26 plus 5, 31 plus 10, 41. So 215 plus 26, it is equal to 241. So number of unmarried males is equal to 26 more than 215, that is equal to 241. Now number of unmarried males are more than unmarried females in Sangyong by 122. Okay, so it means 241 minus 122 is equal to number of unmarried females, right? So 11 minus 2, 9, 3 minus 2, 1. Okay, and 2 minus 1, 1. So unmarried females will be equal to 119. Clear? So he is asking, find the total number of employees. So total number of employees will be equal to total number of males, that is equal to 215 plus 241. So that is 5 plus 1, 6, 1 plus 4, 5, and 2 plus 2, 4. Similarly, calculating total number of females, 254 plus 119. So that is equal to 4913. 516 and 17, 2 and 1, 3. So total number of males are 456, total number of females are 373. Their summation will be equal to 6 and 3, 9, 7 and 5, 12, 4, 3, 7 and 8, 1, 8, 829. This is your answer. Clear? Okay, let's move on to the next one. Number of females in Kia is 207 more than the number of females in Mahindra. So number of females in Mahindra, that is equal to 632 minus 402, that is equal to 230. And number of females in Kia is 207 more than that. So 07 plus 30, 37. Right? Plus 200 plus 200, that is equal to 437. Clear? That is equal to 437. Now, if the sum of married males and married females, married males and married females, that is equal to 235. And now we have to find out the sum of unmarried males. Let's just say it is C, and unmarried females, it is equal to D. So we have to find out the value of C plus D. Now, if you see here, the total sum of A plus B plus C plus D should be equal to total number of males plus total number of females. So 219 plus 437. Right? It should be equal to 219 plus 437. 7 plus 9, 16. Right? 3 plus 1 plus 1, 5. 2 plus 4, 6. Now, A plus B, the value is 235. So C plus D will be equal to 656 minus 235. So that is equal to 6 minus 5, 1, 5 minus 3, 2, 6 minus 2, 4. So the answer is 421. Clear? Okay, let's move on to the next one. If in Mahindra, total number of employees is 14.28%, more than that of Kia, 14.28% more than that of Kia. So it means 14.28% means 1 by 7 more. So that means 1 more than 7. So what it means exactly is that total number of employees in Mahindra in ratio to total number of employees in Kia, that is equal to 8:7. Okay, and then ratio between number of married and number of unmarried females in Denso, unmarried females in Denso and in ratio to total employees in Kia, that is again equal to 1:7. 1:7. Okay. Then find the total number of unmarried females in Denso. Total number of unmarried females in Denso. Now you see total number of people in Mahindra. Total number of people in Mahindra, that is equal to 632. If we see the value of 8 units is equal to 632. So value of 1 unit will be equal to 632 divided by 8. That is equal to 79. So value of 1 unit is equal to 79 here. Clear? Now, according to that, according to the statement, the ratio that we have been given, 8:7. So accordingly, total number of employees in Kia will be equal to 79 into 7, because seven value of 7 units will be equal to 79 into 7. So that is equal to 7 into 9, 63, and we have got 6 as carry. 7 into 7, 49 plus 6, 54. 7 into 79, that is equal to 7 into 80 minus 1. You could have done this way also. So 560 minus 7, that is equal to 553. Clear? You could have done this way as well. So total number of employees in Kia, that is equal to 553. Clear? So now the ratio between unmarried females in Denso, and total number of employees in Kia, that is equal to 1:7. So in short, the value of 7 units, it is equal to 553. So value of 1 unit will be equal to 553 divided by 7. That is equal to again 79. So accordingly, number of females, unmarried females in Denso will be equal to 1:79. That is equal to 79. So this is the whole explanatory method. Is there any other way using which we could have done it faster? Yes, there was. If you see, two different ratios were given in which total number of employees in working in Kia, that number was a common thing, you can say, right? So we could have found out the combined ratio, and that is equal to total number of employees working in Mahindra, that is 8, and total number of people working in Kia is 8 and 7, and unmarried females in Denso will be equal to 1. Okay, so the combined ratio will be equal to 8, 7, 1, right? So now accordingly, we were given that total number of employees in Mahindra were 632. So value of 8 was given as 632, right? So value of 1 unit will be equal to 79. So accordingly, number of unmarried females working in Denso will be equal to 1 multiplied by 79, that is equal to 79. We could have done it in a single go, right? So you should keep your mind open, right, to save time and to improve accuracy. Now, unmarried females is equal to, number of unmarried females is equal to 79, right? So we have the value here. Clear? Let's move on to the next one. The number of married females and unmarried females in Denso are equal. So now total number of females are 158. So 158 divided by 2, that is equal to 79. So 79 will go to the unmarried females column, and 79 will go to the married females column, right? So that is, both are equal now. Now, if the number of married males in Denso is 5 more than married females, so 79 plus 5, 84, then find the difference between unmarried females and unmarried males, right? So, there are 300 employees total, right? Out of which 158 are females. So number of males will be equal to 300 minus 158. 300 minus 158. So 300 minus 158 will be equal to 10 minus 8, 2, 9 minus 5, 4. Right? And 2 minus 1, 1. Clear? So 142. So total number of males are 142, out of which 84 are married. So 84 plus 1600 plus 42 more, right? So that will be equal to 58. So number of unmarried males are 58. Now we have to find out what is the difference between unmarried females. So unmarried females are 79 and unmarried males. Unmarried males are 58. So the difference is 79 minus 58. That is equal to 20. Clear? Okay, now let's move on to the next one. So next DI we have here, it is a caselet DI. Okay, it is a caselet DI. In a caselet DI, the given set of instruction, or you can say information, is already given. Okay, so this, there's a paragraph in which all the information you have been given here. And based on this information, the questions are asked and you have to answer them. So now the question says, a central bank has three regional branches in three different cities, X, Y, and Z. Now name of each branch is on the name of its city, so that doesn't matter here. On January 1st, 2018, the total number of employees working in three regional offices were together were 2400, and out of them, number of employees working in three regional offices X, Y, and Z were 400, 1200, and 800 respectively. The bank has one strange transfer rule and strictly followed, and that is on 1st March of each year, the entire employees of each branch get transferred to other two branches. Means half go to one and half go to other one. And according to bank requirement policy, on 1st December of each year, it required new employees in each branch as 10% of total number of employees working at that time. And it does not recruit any new employees before that or after that. So assume that now you have to assume that none of the employees has left the bank in next 3 years. Okay. So we'll assume that nobody has left the bank nobody leaves the bank in next 3 years. So no, none of the employees has left the bank in past 3 years, or nobody will leave in next 3 years. There was some statement error. Clear? Now, based on this information, we have to work and we have to see the questions here. So if none of the employees had left the bank, then bank has recruited how many number of employees till January 2020. Now, if you see on January 2018, if we see the number of employees working in different banks, A, B, and C, there were like 400, 1200, and 800. 400, 1200, and 800. Okay. Okay, clear. Now the bank has a policy. Bank has a policy that on 1st March, the entire employees of each branch get transferred to other two branches, half to one and other half to one. And on 1st December, the recruitment is done based upon the total number of employees working at that time in a particular branch, and 10% of total number of employees are now recruited on December. So in March 2018, all the 400 employees of X will get transferred either to Y or Z. Okay, will get transferred to Y and Z. That means 200 here and 200 here, right? 200 here and 200 here, right? And the employees from Y and Z will come here. Half of the employees of Y, 600, and half of the employees of Z, 400, will come here. So accordingly, we can see the number of employees working currently in that branch will go to other two branches, and from other two branches, half of the people working there in the respective branches will come here in the current branch here, at which we will सो 600 प्लस 400, सो एक्स में अगर आप देखोगे तो एम्प्लॉयज कितने हो जाएंगे आपके, 1000 हो जाएंगे मार्च में, ठीक है। 600 प्लस 400 कितने हो जाएंगे, 1000 हो जाएंगे। ऐसे ही वाई में क्या होगा, ये 1200 तो कहीं और चले जाएंगे, आधे एक्स में आधे जेड में, जो जेड से हैं वो 400 आ जाएंगे और एक्स से 200 आ जाएंगे, तो टोटल एम्प्लॉयज कितने हो जाएंगे, 600। ऐसे जेड में ये 800 तो कहीं और चले जाएंगे एक्स और वाई में, और एक्स के 200 और वाई के 600 इधर आ जाएंगे, टोटल हो जाएंगे 800। अब दिसंबर 2018 में क्या होगा, रिक्रूटमेंट होगी 10% की, राइट। तो अभी जो दिसंबर 2018 में, क्योंकि कोई छोड़ के तो जा नहीं रहा है, तो जो एक्स में इस टाइम 1000 वर्क कर रहे हैं, तो टोटल रिक्रूटमेंट इसके 10% की होगी, यानी कि 100 की होगी, ठीक है। और वाई में रिक्रूटमेंट 600 के 10% यानी कि 60 की होगी। ऐसे जेड में रिक्रूटमेंट कितने की होगी, 80 की, राइट। अब टोटल नंबर ऑफ एम्प्लॉयज वर्किंग इन थ्री डिफरेंट ब्रांचेस at in December 2018 will be equal to 1000 plus newly recruited 100, and the value will be equal to 1100. 600 plus 60, 660. 800 plus 80, 880. Clear? Similarly, in January 2019, the number of employees working in X, Y, and Z, they will be equal to 1100, 660, and 880. Right? So half, now in March 2019, they will be transferred. Right? So this 1100 will go to some other branch, go to other branches like X, Y, and Z. Right? And from other branches, people will come here. So half of Y, 330, plus half of Z, 440. Similarly, Y के तो सब इधर उधर चले जाएंगे, X के 1100 का हाफ आएगा 550, राइट, प्लस 880 का हाफ आएगा 440। सिमिलरली ये 880 तो चले जाएंगे, तो 1100 का हाफ 550 इधर आएगा और 330 और आएगा, ठीक है। सो इन टोटल द टोटल नंबर ऑफ एम्प्लॉयज वर्किंग देयर विल बी एट द एंड ऑफ मार्च 2019 विल बी 770, 990 एंड 880, ठीक है, 880। नाउ इन दिसंबर 2019, न्यू रिक्रूटमेंट होगी 10% की, यानी कि प्लस 77 इन एक्स, प्लस 99 इन वाई, एंड प्लस 88 इन जेड, राइट। सो टोटल, इन टोटल अगर आप चेक करोगे तो 770 प्लस 77 दैट इज इक्वल टू 7 प्लस 7 14, 847, 9 plus 0, 9, 9, 9, 18, and 9 plus 1, 10. Similarly, 880 plus 88 will be equal to 968. So if you see, at the end of December, the population, the number of employees working was like 847. So yahi hoga January mein bhi, kyunki January mein aur koi activity to honi nahi hai. Theek hai? So January 2020 mein, yahi hogi inki population. ठीक है, तो आप चाहो तो इसको हाईलाइट कर लो अलग अलग ईयर्स में, अलग अलग मंथ्स में। ये मार्च का है सीन, ये दिसंबर का है, ठीक है। अब इसी के बेस पे हमें क्या करना है, क्वेश्चन करना है। ठीक है, अब क्वेश्चन में देख लो आपको क्या चाहिए, ठीक है, क्वेश्चन में देख लेते हैं। How many new employees have been recruited? नए employees कितने recruit हुए हैं January 2020 तक? ठीक है, तो आप new employees की सिर्फ बात करोगे, तो new employees कहाँ कहाँ add हुए हैं? पहले यहाँ पर add हुए थे 100, 60 and 80, total कितने थे? 60 plus 80, 140 plus 100, 240 यहाँ add हुए थे, और उसके बाद next recruitment कब हुई थी? December 2019 में हुई होगी, ठीक है, तो उसमें कितने add हुए थे? 77 plus 99 plus 88, so that is equal to 11, common ले लो, 7 plus 9 plus 8, 9, 7, 16 plus 8, 24, 11 into 24, that is equal to 264, ठीक है, so 240 plus 264, ये add हुए हैं, ठीक है, so that is equal to 0 plus 4, 4, 4 plus 6, 10, 2 plus 2, 4 and 1, 5. Total 504. This is your answer. Itne recruitments hue hain January 2020 tak. Clear? Chaliye. Next question. Number of employees working on April 2019 in branch A. Branch X. Kar lo isko. Branch X and branch Z. Employees working on April 1, 2019 in branch X was how many less than that of working in branch Z at the time? ठीक है, तो April 1, 2019 में branch X में जितने थे, ठीक है, तो April 1, 2019 में branch X में कितने थे? देखो, March 2019 में 770 थे branch X में, ठीक है, और Z में कितने थे? 880 थे. तो मार्च से लेके अप्रैल के बीच में कुछ नया तो हुआ नहीं होगा, ठीक है, तो इन्हीं का डिफरेंस आएगा 770 माइनस 880, ठीक है, 880 यहाँ पे बड़ा है, डिफरेंस की बात हो रही है, सब्ट्रैक्शन की नहीं, तो हम यहीं पे ऐसे माइनस कर देंगे, तो डिफरेंस कितना हो गया 110. क्लियर. नाउ द क्वेश्चन नंबर 3 सेज ऑन फेब्रुअरी 1 2020 इफ द बैंक ऑफर्स 1.6 लाख टू एवरीवन 1 फरवरी 2020 को. तो मतलब जैन 2020 का काउंट हम चेक कर लेंगे पहले, क्योंकि जैन से लेके फेब के बीच में कुछ नहीं होगा, अगली जो होगा ट्रांसफर होगी वो 2020 में होगी, मार्च 2020 में होगी, तो जैन से फेब के बीच में कुछ भी नहीं होना है, तो जैन का ही चेक कर लेते हैं कि कितना है उस टाइम हमारा अकाउंट, ठीक है, उसी के हिसाब से 1.6 लाख टू एवरीवन एज होली बोनस टोटल कितना अमाउंट डिस्ट्रीब्यूट होगा वो हमें चेक करना है. तो टोटल अगर आप जनवरी 2020 की बात करो, सो दैट विल बी इक्वल टू 847 प्लस 1089 प्लस 968. 847 प्लस 1098 प्लस, एक बार दोबारा चेक कर लेते हैं, 1089 प्लस 968, 1089 प्लस 968. सो इसका समीशन कर लो अगर आप, तो 847 प्लस 1089 प्लस 968, ठीक है, तो इसको आप समीशन करेंगे, 8 प्लस 9 17 प्लस 7 24, 2 कैरी आएगा 2 प्लस 4 6 6 8 14, 14 प्लस 6 20 0 6 20 20 का 0 रखेंगे, 2 कैरी चला जाएगा 2 एंड 8 10 10 0 10 10 प्लस 9 19, 1 कैरी चला गया 1 एंड 1 2, सो 2940. टोटल टोटल नंबर ऑफ पर्संस कितने हैं इन जनवरी 2000 जनवरी 2020. सो हर पर्सन को 1.6 लाख मिलेगा, हर पर्सन को 1.6 लाख मिलेगा, तो टोटल कितना कितना हो जाएगा हमारा खर्चा वो बताना है, ठीक है. सो 1.6 16 इनटू 4 64, ठीक है, ये ऐसे चला जाएगा 16 इनटू 9 दैट इज इक्वल टू 144, ठीक है, 14 चला गया कैरी में, 32 प्लस 44 6 एक डॉट यहाँ लगा दो, 4646.4 लैक्स. सो दिस वाज योर आंसर. तो ये थे आपके दो सेट डीआईस के. आई होप आपको सारी चीजें समझ में आई होंगी और अप्रोच भी और कैसे हम कैलकुलेट करते हैं चीजों को, ठीक है. सो आई होप ये सब चीजें समझ में आई हैं. इफ यू हैव एनी डाउट्स यू कैन रेज योर डाउट्स एंड इट विल बी रिजॉल्वड. एंड आप इस बैच को भी अगर आप और डिटेल में पढ़ना चाहते हैं, हर एक टॉपिक को हर एक चीज को अगर आप ऐसे ही डिटेल में पढ़ना चाहते हैं, सो यू कैन सब्सक्राइब टू आवर बैच एज वेल, सब्सक्राइब टू आवर कोर्स एज वेल. एंड इन द प्रीवियस सेशंस आल्सो वी हैव सॉल्व हु हैव बॉट आवर बैच, वी कैन सी सक्सेस स्टोरीज इन IBPS आरआरबी स्केल 1 एंड फॉर स्केल 2. We also teach for different courses, some other two courses like Bank of India Credit Officer, Vijay Bank Credit Officer, Bank of India Credit Officer. Like you can see a lot of success stories here. Your face could be the next one here in the success stories in the next upcoming session, right? So don't wait. Just if you like the content, if you like the way we teach, you can subscribe to the course. So see you in the next session. Till then, take care. Bye bye. Keep studying.